Hey, how's it going, guys? So if you're checking into this video, it's because you either linked from something else or you just stumbled across it from the previous video, which was a goal setting one. Now, if you haven't seen that one yet, I highly recommend you check it out. It's gonna be linked right up here. And in this video, I kind of made it more in a vlog format. It's gonna have a lot of key points in it, but I just wanted to really walk through some important things that you guys could really implement this year to get closer to your goals. My ultimate goal was just to really create a method, a very simple to follow method, where you could create the plans and goals that you envision and then create actionable steps day after day that will compound to create those results. All right, so it sounds a little complicated, but look, it's gonna be pretty easy. So we'll just start talking right about it. For the most part, I highly recommend that you guys remove distractions when watching this video and really watch it all the way through. Now, if you purchase this Start and Conquer Planner ASAP that I created, if you purchase this, I really appreciate you guys for doing that, but you didn't have to purchase it in order to follow along. The link is gonna be in the description for those of you that do wanna purchase this and get some of the bonus content also included with it. I'm not making much money off this, guys, so right up front, I'll let you know I'm probably making like $3. Wasn't my goal. My goal was to really get you guys this system that I've been working on for the last couple years. I started with like making plans and goals that were, I would say, were what people normally do when they set forward a plan. Like, for the most part, they create an idea, they have an ultimate vision that they want, and then they'll start planning for it like every day, or maybe every week, or scattered in between. And then at the end of the year, you don't really get to where you want to go because you didn't really set forward that right plan that you needed. So my goal with this book was to give you guys an easy to follow method. Like, literally, it's going to lay it out word for word, step by step, right in here, and you guys will be able to follow right along. So once again, I think the biggest thing that I could say is that don't overwhelm yourself when you're planning and you're preparing this. There's no need to really follow it word for word. So some of you guys that are more the creative type, is like, it's very intimidating when you start creating goals and you start trying to achieve, you put stuff up on the vision and then you miss it and then you get discouraged. So don't plan to follow this word for word. It's all right if you don't. It really is, guys. I just want to make sure that I preach that to you so you guys don't get overwhelmed with the information that's coming. As long as you implement a little bit about what we discussed today, you guys will be a lot closer than you would have been if you didn't do this, all right? And for the ones that are going to follow this word for word, I mean, the only thing I would say is don't be afraid to take this lightheartedly. And if you don't actually do some of these steps, don't beat yourself up about it. I know that sometimes the high overachievers, people that have the high drive, they don't accomplish something, they also get discouraged. But for the most part, guys, take it lightheartedly. Really walk through it. It's very simple. It just takes a little bit of your time every single day, but it's gonna set you up to really put you in the position that you want. I wanna say one of the major lessons I've learned over the last few years of entrepreneurship and business and just and everything general in life, one of the biggest things I've learned personally is that the more shots you take, the more shots you're gonna miss. And what I mean by that is, if you're out there making moves every single day and you're out there putting it out there and risking it, you're gonna miss a few shots, all right? But at the end of the day, those few shots that you miss are gonna be very minimal compared to the big wins that you gain, all right? So it's just like Michael Jordan said, you know, he's failed over 300 times, lost over 300 games, but the more he fails, the more he won. And it doesn't matter how many mentors or people you have in your circle, like, ultimately it's gonna be up to you with how you run your life. All right, there really is no blueprint that's created that's gonna guarantee you any success. There's no such thing as that. All right, so just be completely clear about that. So this planner is gonna get you closer to that, and this planning system is gonna really fine-tune some of those details for you. But at the end of the day, guys, it's up to you to just take action, all right? And that's what this planner is really about. It's about taking action. It's about planning, executing, and then ultimately accomplishing ASAP, all right? It says it right there in the title, just an everyday reminder that I created. So as long as you're planning, and more importantly, as long as you're executing on those plans, you will accomplish things, all right? It'll get you to where you wanna be, and it'll get you a lot faster than if you didn't plan and you didn't execute, or if you executed and didn't plan. Because then you're kind of just running around in circles. All right, so let's get right into it now. I don't want to take up much more of your time, but like I said, guys, this is going to be a video where you really want to chill out. You really want to take a minute, grab a glass of water, grab a glass of something, and literally let's just follow along with it so you guys can really learn all the details. All right, let's get into it. Now, one of the things that I do want to point out is the system that I want to discuss was a was a combination of my personal planning, my planning with mentors that built multi-million dollar companies, Fortune 500s, have scaled big brands that you guys see today, really learning some behind the scene details, masterminding with Navy SEALs, people who are going through the training, who have graduated from training. Every little detail that I've gotten, I really tailored this plan and I really created something that was easy to follow along, and I created it for myself more than anything. So the foundation of this planner I created was really based along the lines of the compound effect. Now, for those of you guys that have or haven't heard of the compound effect, what it ultimately means, like in finance, it means if you were to invest, say, $1,000 at a constant 12 to 20% interest rate, that's $1,000 year after year, like over the span of 20, 30, 40 years, would generate you over like $500,000 to $800,000, depending on the return of interest year after year. Now, that's called a compound effect. And I'm pretty sure there's another technical term to it, but for the most part, guys, a compound effect, all right? And that's really where some of the foundation of this is actually founded. It's based along the principles that if every single day you're doing something that's compounding results day after day, kind of like compounding interest. So if you're doing something every single day, at the end of the month, you would have accomplished something pretty big. Now, if you continue that path every single month, at the end of the year, you would have accomplished some major goals. All right, so that's really the ultimate vision of this planner, and it's literally the motto of my life. And it's, this thing is fucking, it's really cool. Like I wouldn't spend any time trying to print it. I wouldn't spend any time trying to share it if I didn't personally believe in it, and if it didn't personally get me results as well. All right, so that's the basis of this book. It's really founded on the compound effect, really founded on every single day what you do is getting you closer to your goals, and it does it by not overwhelming you. That's the most important thing. When you have goals so big, it's very easy to be overwhelmed because there's so much to do. There's like so much shit to do. And then you're like, where do I even start? What do I do here? What do I do there? And it's very overwhelming. So just look at the plan day by day. It won't be overwhelming. You'll be able to execute. But to do that day by day goal, you have to think big picture and bring it down to small picture. So this is where we're going to jump into this book right now. All right, let's get it. So if you're following along with this book, if you purchase this book, then there's going to be some instructions in the front. So you could always refer to the instructions in case I miss anything here in this video. But for the most part, I do want to cover a little bit more in this video than I would cover in this book. All right, so to begin with, guys, I highly suggest that you really challenge yourself to create a 10-year vision. All right, really challenge yourself to create a vision, outline a path for you. Where do you want to be in 10 years? Where do you want to be? Really take a moment. So I want to challenge you, if you're following along right now, just pause this video. And if you're in a room that's silent enough, or if you're in an area that's silent enough to really work through this exercise, just do it right now. Take a moment to do it. Open up a piece of paper or a notebook that you're going to start and really try to visualize exactly where you would see yourself in 10 years from now. All right, I challenge you to do that. It's going to be very eye-opening. It's going to be very challenging for you to try to do that. But just remember, 10 years flies by so fast, guys. Like, still remember high school days. For those of you guys who are 12, 14, 18 watching these videos, like, time is going to fly by so fast, you wouldn't believe it. So write down where you'd want to be 10 years from now, regardless if you can think about it, whatever comes to mind, just write it down. All right. That's going to really help you at least lay down a foundation for what's to come right after that. But don't take it too seriously either. Don't overthink it. If you can't really think about it, where you'd actually envision yourself being 10 years from now, just write down what you'd like to have accomplished within those 10 years. Like, what have you accomplished and where are you at? You know, like, just really challenge yourself to think 10 years from now, all right? That's gonna be the first step in writing these goals. The next step you guys are gonna take is you're gonna think about where you're gonna be at 5 years from now. Now, if you really thought about the 10-year plan, 5 years is gonna be half of that, right? So technically, you should be halfway through where your 10-year plan should be. So if your 10-year plan was to build a multi-million dollar media corporation that produced movies and all kinds of home entertainment and technology, then 5 years from now, you would have at least have started a successful business in the media and home technology business, for instance. Or whether it's 10 years from now, you want to have the biggest streetwear brand, you know, similar to whatever, Stussy or Supreme or Diamond. 5 years from now, you should have a very successful clothing line that's generating multi-million dollar revenues and be in position to either sell or scale with a partner or with bigger partners, right? So the 5-year goal is gonna be halfway to your 10-year vision, but this one should be a little more clearer, guys. This one should be a little bit more thought out because 5 years goes by super fast. And when I say super fast, like, Think about 5 years ago. Where were you at 5 years ago? Whether it was your 18, whether it was your 7, whether it was your 15, or whether it was you just graduated high school, whatever your situation was, think about it. And now think about how fast that flew. So this one, you really wanna be a little bit more clear about where you're at, and you really wanna have a pretty good picture. So then that way it helps you as we're progressing through this plan. All right, so the third step you're gonna take is gonna be your 1-year goal. Now this one right here, guys, this one right here should be one that you could at least picture yourself being from now. All right, this one should be a little bit more easy to visualize. And at the same time, fifth of the way from your 5-year goal, right? So your 1-year goal should be a good step forward to accomplishing your 5-year goal. So whatever your 5-year goal was, this 1-year goal is a fraction of that 5-year goal. So now you really wanna kinda take that big picture and say, okay, a year from now, what am I doing to cut, to progress a fifth of the way there, right? So you wanna be very detailed with this 1-year goal. And the reason that it has a lot more lines is, you know, there's a lot more things to accomplish, all right? Way more things to accomplish in the 1-year goal. And there's actionable things here that you wanna accomplish. In the 5-year, this is a 5-year vision because you're kind of visualizing where you'd want to be 5 years from now. Same thing as a 10-year vision, all right? But your 1 year is your goals. These are the goals that you're gonna take this year in order to accomplish what your 5-year vision is, okay? It's gonna get you closer to your 5-year vision, and then we're gonna literally work through this thing where you're gonna create goals that you're gonna be able to follow along with and really measure for those results, all right? So your 1-year goal is what you're gonna accomplish 12 months from now. Whenever you start this planner, whether you start it in March, whether you start it in July, whether you start it in February, whenever you start this planner, it doesn't matter. It's 12 months from now. Now for the 1-year goal, you really wanna think about all aspects of your life, okay? It's gonna be all aspects of life, not just business. It's gonna be personal, it's gonna be family, it's gonna be finance, it's gonna be health. It's gonna be all aspects of your life because, guys, life connects, all right? We're all connected. There is no such thing as a work-life balance. There's no such thing as a balance. It's the sooner you learn that everything matters and everything is important in life, you're gonna start creating time for each of these things, all right? So this 1-year goal, I want you to challenge yourself by putting down your business goals, but then also putting down your personal health fitness goals, putting down your relationship goals, putting down any family goals, putting down any community goals you may have, anything that you wanna really accomplish within this 1 year. And I really challenge you to write down every single one of them, all right? Doesn't matter how crazy it is. I want you to think big. I want you to just like literally challenge yourself to think of the craziest shit you can think of while creating this 1-year goal. And the reason I say to think of the craziest shit and not to be scared to put big goals is because if you put these big goals, you're gonna challenge yourself to take bigger actions throughout the day. And don't get discouraged if those bigger actions you're not able to reach. If you had a crazy goal of wanting to get $10 million, for instance, if you would have planned to get $10 million, you probably would fall short, but you'd still hit somewhere in the millions, right? But if you were to plan to get, you know, whether it's $50,000, then you're gonna fall short and it'll probably be a couple thousand. So it's whatever you're really comfortable with, whatever you really wanna challenge yourself in growth-wise, but I really challenge yourself to do something massive because that's the only way that you're gonna overachieve what you ever thought you'd achieve, and you'd be like, at the end of the year, you'd be like, what the fuck did I just do? You know, like, for the most part, challenge yourself with the 1-year goal, mix it all with family, friends, mix it with business, mix it with your personal life, challenge yourself to be a better version of you, of whoever you are right now, 12 months from now. All right, so now that you have your 1-year goals, whether it's 20, whether it's 15, whatever big goals you have this year, now that you got them all there, I really want you to just quickly analyze it. Like if you're just starting with planning, chances are that you have scattered goals, meaning that like you have 5 businesses you want to start over here, and then you have two things you want to accomplish personally, then you have five things you want to do with family, and then you have like two things you have to do with work. You know, if you're anything like that, like it's completely I've been in that situation, guys. I literally have held two jobs, went to school, I had two businesses, and it was crazy, it was nuts. So trust me, you can do it. There's a way to do it, but it's not gonna create the biggest results you could possibly create because you're so scattered everywhere, nothing really connects. So if you're writing down these 1 year goals and you have all those ideas, I don't say don't do them all, but just start to fine tune where some of the focus is gonna really be. Where do you really want the focus to be? Because whatever you're focusing your mind on is what you're gonna be accomplishing, all right? And it's very difficult to accomplish multiple things if you don't have the capital resources to do it. Meaning the money to do it, all right? There's gonna be a lot of money and a lot of things involved with each of the things that you wanna accomplish. So the more goals you have, the more money it's gonna require, the more time it'll require, the more people you need to work with. It's just a lot to manage, all right? So I really would say narrow it down to three at the most, but it's really up to you guys. I'm not here to tell you how to run your life, but I do recommend that you narrow those down because you're not gonna accomplish very much if you're everywhere, all right? So with that in mind, we're gonna jump into the quarterly goals. Now what the quarterly goals are literally like chunks of 3 months. So in a year, there's 12 months, so there's 4 quarters, meaning that every quarter is 3 months. Whether this is January, February, March, first quarter, April, May, June, second quarter, and so on. All right, so a quarter is 3 months of the year. All right, so it doesn't matter when you started planning this, just make sure that you keep in mind the calendar quarters, which is January, February, March, and then there's whatever quarters you create for your own personal life, all right? So now that you have this full year plan and you're able to really look at it, the quarterly goals are gonna be a breakdown, a snapshot of accomplishments that you need to get to reach your yearly goal, okay? So say you had 20 different things you wanted to accomplish in a year, okay? Now, quarter one, you technically have to accomplish 5 of them. If there was 20 of them, and now you have 3 months chunk of time, then in those 3 months, you should get through a fourth of those goals that you set yourself for. Okay, so then you're gonna start choosing some of those goals that you have, and you're gonna start putting them into quarter one goals. Okay, meaning these are the 4 or 5 things that I wanna accomplish in these 3 months. And it's okay if they're pretty massive in those 3 months. Challenge yourself with trying to fit a good amount in there, because then as we're going through this book, you'll see how it's gonna break down. All right, so do that for quarter one. What do you wanna accomplish the first 3 months? And really challenge yourself to thinking about what will make the impact in quarter two. So if quarter one was about creating designs, launching your website, you know, registering your name, setting up business operations, finding logistical partners, if that was quarter one, that's going to prepare you for quarter two, which is launching, marketing, sales. Quarter three might be something like influencer strategies, increasing sales, events, trade shows. Quarter four might be trade shows, sales reps, whatever it is. Like, there's things that come before some things, so you really have to start organizing which things need to come before others while you're doing this quarterly goal. The purpose of this quarterly plan is that it's going to allow you to see what needs to come first. All right, you have to crawl before you walk, but in order to crawl, you need to get your ass off of that fucking seat when you're a baby. You know, you need to start crawling on the ground, then you need to start getting up. You're gonna fall, whatever it is. Like, we all start somewhere. So quarter one is gonna be, where are you starting at these first 3 months that are gonna position you to be in a better position quarter two? And then quarter two is gonna fall into quarter three, and then quarter three will supplement quarter four. So by the end of the year, you would have accomplished those goals, but you have to do it in an orderly fashion. If you start jumping around to try to do a bunch of other stuff, you'll see that everything else starts to unclick. And then at the end of the year, you'll just be like everywhere. Like, you'll have a lot of scattered accomplishments and shit. But yeah, follow this, all right? For sure, follow it. All right, so now that you have your quarterly goals, you wanna focus on only the first quarter. All right, so now that you have that map out, that quarterly goals sheet is going to be your blueprint in order to accomplish your 1 year goal, right? So now what you wanna do is you wanna start setting the goals for month one. Okay, so month one goals are gonna be things that you need to accomplish during the first 30 days of that 90-day calendar, right? So of those 3 months. So your first month's goals are gonna be, what do you need to accomplish first in order to reach those other ones in that first quarter? So now what we're essentially doing is we're taking that chunk of goals for quarter one, and we're breaking them down into what you actually want to accomplish that first month. All right, this is going to be the first month's accomplishments. What are you doing the first month that will roll over to the second month? Meaning that because you accomplished the goals this month, it allows you to do second month, and then it moves forward to the third month. You get the idea, right? This is a compounding, the compounding success formula, whatever you want to call it. The compound effect is what this essentially is doing. All right, so I want you to really think about the big goals that you want to reach this month that will move you towards success this year, okay? These are the goals you want to accomplish in the first month that will get you closer to your one-year goal. All right, so now we get into the meat and bones of it. It's going to be your weekly goals, right? These are the goals that are more near-term, because I truly believe that the reason that a lot of us, and me personally, do not accomplish some of the goals in the past, or are not accomplishing some of our goals, is because we don't have actionable steps day in and day out. So the weekly goals, think of it as your near-term goal, like what you need to accomplish in 7 days, because that's essentially what you're doing. You're working towards a weekly goal. So now you're gonna take those monthly goals that we broke down. We broke down those monthly goals for month one, all right? Only month one. You broke down the goals you wanna accomplish month one. So now you're gonna take that monthly goal that you have for month one, and you're gonna say, okay, what do I need to accomplish this week? This week only, to get me closer to the 1 month goal. Now you're gonna challenge yourself a little bit with what is more important to accomplish this week that'll help me get to accomplish second week, third week, and fourth week. So similar to what we've been discussing, guys, is work on the tasks that matter first on the first week that'll allow you to get into the goals that matter second week and the third week, and then by the end of the fourth week, you'd be able to see how well you did and really be able to measure what worked and what didn't. All right, so weekly goals, write them down here. Personally, I think I have about 28, 35 goals every week. They're like 35 to sometimes even 40 goals every week. And that could be anything, ranging from, you know, what I want to run my mile time in. One of my personal goals this year is to run a mile time in 5:30. You know, so that means that I need to go out and fucking train, maybe do some weightlifting or run up some hills. Like, I need to start doing things this week that'll get me closer to my monthly goal of running a shorter mile time. And it could be anything from your business operations, whatever you want, whatever you're accomplishing this month, you want to put down those things you need to accomplish this week that will move you forward in that, okay? Like I said, this is for personal, business, family, relationships. Make sure you're writing them and you make sure that you're accomplishing them. Okay, so now we jump into the meat and bones of it. This is gonna be, you're gonna be creating a strategy on a day-to-day basis that is gonna get you closer to your weekly goals. So what we're gonna start off with, as you see, this is a snapshot of the daily goals. This is what's going to be your daily planner. This is the meat and bones of the entire operation, guys. And like I said, it revolves around your entire life, not just business. So this isn't one of those like very complicated formula planners that's like, if you do this and then you write some shit here and then you do this and then it's like you get to clean the toilet and take out the trash today or some shit that's like it's very easy to do. This isn't very easy, guys. This is actually going to challenge you to think about some stuff. So what we're going to cover right now, I'm just going to tell you guys the vision side of it. It's always important for you to have a very strong vision of what you want to accomplish within the next 5, 10 years, within the next year, however far along you can think. Try to think about it 5, 10 years out. And what you're gonna wanna do is you want to write it down every single day. This should be the first thing you fill out in your planner. It should be your vision of what you want life to be. And to really supplement that, you can create a vision board. I'm not gonna include it in this, but you can create a vision board, start putting some content together of what you wanna accomplish, because I'm telling you guys, it really helps to visualize what you want to be, where you want to be at, who you want to be, because that's what's ultimately going to give you that drive for you to accomplish this every single day. All right, so the vision is going to be the first thing you fill out. The second thing you're going to fill out is the objectives. So meaning, what are the objectives for this day, right? What's the objectives for your first day of the week? What do you need to accomplish? And you're only going to be working on this So if you're opening up this daily planner, you're not gonna fill out every single day of the week, all right? I just want you to fill out one day. If you started on Monday, just fill out Monday. That's it, guys. Of course, if you're trying to schedule some things ahead of time, maybe you can write a little bit to just that way you're filling up your planner and you're filling up your schedule. But the goal is to have your goals written out at the start of the week. So then that way you're able to think about what you need to accomplish on Monday, and you're only thinking about what you need to accomplish on Monday based on what you needed to accomplish at the start of the week. This is the way that you're gonna stay on track, guys, because so much things is gonna happen where it could change your week. You know, somebody could call and say, hey, can you help me out here, or some random stuff. I'm telling you guys, life happens. But if you're in charge of your time and you're letting people know that, hey, from this time to this time, I am focused 100%, pretend I'm at work or pretend I'm not on earth at that time. Like, just let me work and don't bother me. You turn off your cell phones, turn off your whatever, Facebook, MySpace, whatever you're on, right? Turn it all off, because those time blocks are gonna be how you accomplish some of these goals for the week. So we broke them down, guys. It's gonna be from 6 a.m. to 9 p.m. And of course, you could write a lot more. There's a lot of lines here, but just fill out exactly what you're gonna be accomplishing throughout the day. It's good that you hold yourself accountable for these daily goals, because like I said, if you don't start setting those daily goals, other people will. And what I mean by that is other people will demand time from you that don't fall in line with your yearly goal. Okay, so always keep that in mind. If you're not in control of your time, somebody else is. And of course, if you have a job, or if you have a part-time job or a full-time job, whatever that is, it's completely understandable. So now when you go to work, you'll know exactly what times you're gonna be saying, okay, go to work. If you have a lunch break or something, maybe you can accomplish something in that lunch break, whatever it is, or maybe you can meet a new relationship, or make it a goal to use your job to get you further along with whatever goals that you have, right? But you do wanna put it down here, and then you do wanna allocate the rest of the day's time into the daily planner, all right? So you do wanna allocate the rest of your hours into completing your goals. So what you're gonna do is every single day when you wake up, you're gonna be opening up these pages and you're gonna go right through it. You put the date, the objectives, the vision, and then you're gonna map out your time block every single day that you're waking up, all right? This is gonna be important. At the end of the week, there's gonna be a note section. In this note section is going to be pretty much anything that really stuck out. So anything that stuck out to you this week, whether it was a quote, whether it was something somebody said, something somebody you met with, or maybe it was a lesson that you learned, write it down in this notes section, because you're always gonna be able to reference back on weeks to just see what the highlight was of that week. It's almost like a personal journal in your planner. Just give you a couple notes, give you a couple pages to just write those notes, guys. You don't have to write in it, but in case something comes up, you never know. Sometimes when you write things with pen and paper, something sticks and then you have to reference it. But at the end of the week, one of the things that you do want to work on is the weekly reflection. Now, the weekly reflection is pretty much exactly what it says here, guys. It's the successes of the week. You want to praise yourself for all the successes you accomplished. So based on your weekly goals, you're going to go through it and you're going to see, okay, what have I accomplished? Check mark it, highlight it, whatever, however you want to do it, cross it out. Check to see what you've accomplished and then reflect on it at the end of the week. So if your end of the week is on Sunday, mine is personally on Sunday, you're gonna say, okay, this week I accomplished this, I accomplished this. I felt great because I ran a 5K and I won first place. You know, I felt great because we closed on deals. I felt great because whatever it is, highlight your successes, guys. It's easy to get discouraged, but if you have some successes, it's gonna move you along, okay? And that's the purpose, that's the reason why I put this in this book. It's also equally important to note down some of the failures. Now, this was something that me and a really good friend of mine, he's going through the whole Navy SEALs thing, and me and him would meet every single week, and we'd go through the successes and failures of our previous week. What I really liked about that was the fact that we were able to give ourselves high fives for accomplishing what we said we were gonna go out and accomplish, but then we'd reflect as to why we didn't accomplish something. So maybe if you had a goal and you didn't reach it, what was the reason that you didn't reach it? Really challenge yourself to think about why you didn't, okay? Sometimes it's just, okay, I didn't have enough time. But then it could be even more detailed, like, well, if I didn't, you know, hang out with my friend, or if I didn't answer the call that ended up making me go to Facebook, and then I spent 10 hours on Facebook, then I would have been able to accomplish this goals, right? You just really want to note down the reason why you didn't accomplish some of these goals. Whatever the reason is, note it down, because then every single week you're going to start seeing a pattern, okay? So you'll start noticing a pattern of the reasons why you haven't accomplished something. And that pattern will allow you to say, wait, hold a minute, wait on. I'm never accomplishing some of these goals because of X, Y, and Z. All right, so then you'll be able to challenge yourself to stop doing X, Y, and Z the next week, right? So make sure you're writing your successes and your failures, because that's how you learn from them, guys. You're gonna learn from both, all right? You don't learn from just winning. You learn from also failing on some of these. That's completely fine. When I started mine last, about a year and a half ago, I'd have like 28 goals that I had for the week. And then I'd accomplish maybe when I first started, I was only accomplishing like 12. And then I started accomplishing 15, then 20. And right now I'm at about 23. So I'm like, I really need to increase my goals, because if I'm freaking getting A's on this thing, it means I'm not trying hard enough, right? But just know that at the end of every week, it's okay that you didn't accomplish all of them, but just know, really think about why you didn't, okay? I wasn't accomplishing some of mine because I was scattered. I had all different goals and they weren't aligning perfectly together. They weren't all working to build one another. So as soon as I started building them one another, I started knocking these out a lot easier. Everything flowed, everything worked right, okay? So I challenge you to do the same. Really organize yourself to see what is and isn't working. All right, guys, so that's pretty much the formula. Once you write down your 10-year, your 5-year, your 1-year, your quarterly, your monthly, and then you start working on the weekly, and then you start working on each day, trust me, it's gonna take away that fear of like, holy shit, I got a lot of stuff to do this year. I got too much to do this year. How do I accomplish it? It's gonna take that away and say, okay, I got these amount of things to do this week. It's a lot easier. It can still be a little complicated sometimes. But then you sit down and you actually say, what is one or two of the things, or maybe three or five of the things I'm gonna accomplish today? That makes it makes life so much easier, guys, because you're not worried about that big mountain anymore. That mountain is there, you're gonna climb it, but it's gonna take step after step after step to get up there. Okay, it's gonna take step by step, and it's gonna take some power, and it's gonna take some energy for you to do it, and it's gonna take some focus for you to get up there. But it's going to happen on a day-to-day basis, on a step-by-step basis. And that's the reason why this isn't an overwhelming thing. It just means that you need to get started with really mapping out your long-term goals and your long-term visions, because everything you do on a day-to-day basis should create some sort of result. If you're looking back every year and thinking, where the hell have I been, because you haven't been tracking anything, then you don't know where you need to go. Okay, you're not gonna know what direction you're headed because you haven't started in any direction. You've been doing circles. All right, get out of the circle thing and start doing a straight freaking narrow path and start saying, I'm gonna fucking knock down that door, and then I'm gonna go into that house and I'm gonna freaking accomplish some shit. All right, so once you're literally gonna do this day in, day out, week after week, month after month. And like I said, this planner is for 6 months. So at the end of 6 months, you're gonna look back and you're gonna really think about some of the accomplishments you had. All right, so what were some of the accomplishments you made in 6 months? All right, this is gonna be important for you to say, I am halfway through the year now. I am halfway through my 12-month goal, and how much closer am I? You may think about, okay, now I'm 6 months through the year and what have I accomplished? You know, what can I do better this next 6 months that is gonna get me closer to my year? Okay, what can I do a little bit different every single day in order to improve my results, or really to improve my accomplishments? Okay, so this is a 6-month planner. It'll take you through the first 6 months of your 12-month plan. If you need a reorder, just go ahead and click the link in the description. If you haven't ordered it, the link is in the description. And once again, guys, I appreciate you guys taking the time to purchase this, to follow along with this video. I really hope it helps you guys. For those of you guys that don't have the means to purchase it, I completely understand, guys. It's the reason that I went into detail in order for you guys to also see what the strategy is. You can just follow along with the notebook. I mean, I did that for years, just like map out the notebook, create the 1 year, 10 year, whatever type of vision, and then just start working through it. I just always found it easier for me to actually print out my own sheets. Like, I'd actually print out all these sheets myself, and I'd print them out at the beginning of every month, and it was just a bunch of paper, and it was you know, having to hole punch it, having to put it in a binder and then hopefully not lose it or somebody take it or drop it off somewhere. So I made it really, really simple for you to just get started in this plan. The Start and Conquer ASAP Planner is available through the links below. Once again, I appreciate you guys' support, and I really, really, truly hope that you guys are able to accomplish your goals this year. Make sure you keep me updated wherever you're at, whatever goals you've accomplished. Make sure to tag me. I'm on Instagram. Let's connect on there. I'm going to be launching a lot of other videos, but just keep me updated with this, guys. I really like when you guys reach out and you tell me where you're at. It's always freaking awesome. So we'll stay connected and we'll keep grinding. We'll keep working together. All right. Talk soon. Bye.